please.
ओम गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतान शृण्वन्नुतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात्परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम डियर फ्रेंड्स, यस्टर्डे वी मिस्ड ए क्लास। आई एम सॉरी बिकॉज आई वाज अवे इन ए प्लेस कॉल्ड काकीनाड। देर वाज अ मीटिंग बाय वन स्वामीजी, परिपूर्णानंद स्वामी, हू इज अ डिसाइपल ऑफ स्वामी दयानंद। देर वाज अ मीटिंग ऑन हिंदू धर्म परिरक्षण। It may sound rather ironical that we are talking about protection of Hinduism in our own country, but that is a fact. So we had a meeting yesterday, I could not come. So today we will resume. We were reading this line regarding this three lokas, lokatraya sadhanam. We completed, but there was a query that this last line was not very clearly explained. So I will again read that line. Dharma jignyasottara kalam lokatraya sadhanam, that is, after a person takes a wife, dhara parigrahad anantaram, after taking a wife, he thinks of dharma jignyasa. He has already done some dharma jignyasa during his student days. The reading of the first portion of Veda, the first part of the Veda, it means that he has already done some dharma jignyasa. And that dharma jignyasa, he has to put it into practice after getting married. So then he thinks of attaining this three types of wealth for attaining these three lokas. Three types of wealth are required for attaining or for achieving these three lokas. Lokatraya is daiva, manushya loka, pitru loka and deva loka. For achieving this manushya loka, the wealth required is children, because the son is the person. I told you, puranat trayate iti putraha. So the putra, in a way, he is supposed to complete what is all the ritual which you have to complete. So he is a person who assists you in all this mundane in the sense, this worldly activities. So he is a man who will assist you in achieving this world, manushya loka. Pitru loka, there are some other rituals for attaining. Number one, to say propitiate your own forefathers, and number two, so that you will also be eligible to go there. So there are certain karmas which will make you eligible to go there, and also to propitiate your forefathers who are there. Three generations of forefathers are supposed to be there in the Pitruloka. Thereafter, you have to have this manushya. This is daivam vittam is required. Daivam vittam is required, that is in the shape of karma. In the shape of karma means the karma which is prescribed in the Vedas, that is the daivam vittam. That is prescribed for achieving the devaloka. So three types of lokas are to be achieved by three types of wealth. So that is the general scheme of things regarding lokatraya. And then usually all the karmis, karmi means one who is interested in a karma. So all the karmis, they will be confining themselves to attaining these three lokas only. And then not many people will be interested in atmaloka. Atmaloka, I again told you, we should not visualize in a three-dimensional plane that there is some other Atmaloka which is over and above all these Pitruloka and all that. Atmaloka is, that is only metaphorically it is called Loka, it is not a separate place, it is not a physical place. So Atma is there everywhere, and all these Lokas which we talk about, they are their appearances within the same Atmaloka. They are all appearances within the same Atmaloka. So that we have to keep in mind. Whenever we use the word Atmanam eva lokam icchantaha, Atmalokam and all that, we should not think that this is another loka which is high and above. That three-dimensional thinking, we have to totally get out of it. So tatra manusham vittam karma rupam pitruloka prapti sadhanam vidyam cha daivam vittam. Vidya is that upasana. Vidya, I said, it does not refer to Atma vidya, it refers to upasana. Vidya, there are two meanings. Depending on the context, we have to see the meaning. So, vidyam cha daivam vittam devaloka prapti sadhanam. Then he also quotes, gives an example, not example, gives that quotation from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. So kamayata iti avidya kamavata eva sarvani karmani srautadini darshitani. I think we completed up to this point. So this I did not explain in the last class. That is so kamayata. So kamayata means saha. Saha is he. Kamayata, that Hiranyagarbha, he does not refer to the absolute Brahman. He does not refer to that absolute supreme reality, Brahman. It refers to Hiranyagarbha. So kamayata jaya me syat. So it is referring to a person who is a karmi. A karmi who is interested, karmi means a person who is interested in the karma, who is having desires. And who are these people? This refers to all those who are eligible to do karma. And in the society, there is a, in that Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, commentary also says, Varni. Varni is one who is in these three Varnas, not the last Varna, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, we talked about the four Varnas. These three Varnas, they are the Adhikrutas, they are the eligible people. That is practically every section of the society, excluding the servants. Only the servants were excluded, but all other people were supposed to do this. They were supposed to go through this process of karma. They were supposed to achieve this lokatraya. So it was enjoined on them to do all these karmas. This is again part of the drill for the well-being of the society. So this Varni, then Shankara Bhashyam there, it also says, Koshakaravat Atmanam Veshtayati. It is not here. Shankara Bhashya for that Brihadaranyaka Mantra. Brihadaranyaka Mantra is So Kamayata Jayame Syat. There he talks about karma. And then a karmi, he is something like a cocoon. We know that there is a cocoon from out of which that silk worm comes out. So initially that silk worm, it ties itself in that cocoon. So this gentleman, this person who is doing karma, Koshakaravat Atmanam Veshtayati. He actually ties himself like a cocoon does. So that is how this Karyakarana Sanghata Lakshmana, Lakshanaha Atma. Atma here means not the supreme soul. It means the individual, the person, the jiva. So this man, by doing karma, he ties himself, he binds himself like a cocoon. So that is what that line says. So avidya kamavata eva sarvani karmani srautadini darshitani. All these srautadini, srauta plus adi, it means srauta smartha. Whenever they say adi, etc., we have to presume that, though it is not mentioned, we have to presume that srauta karma and also smartha karma. All these things, they have been prescribed for an avidya kamavan. For avidya kamavan is the word, avidya kamavataha is the shashti, shashti vibhakti. Avidya kamavan means avidyavan plus kamavan. That means he is having avidya and that is why he is having the desires. So avidya kamavata eva. So Shankaracharya is making a very slightly rather insulting statement for somebody who is fixated in karma, who is somebody who is having a fixation in karma. So he is ultimately, karma we are not denigrating. We are not saying it is something bad. The idea is that we should not get stuck to that level. We have to come out of that level. We have to come out of that level and see what is the higher goal in life. So that is it. In fact, I was reading one, I wanted to tell the story of Parashurama. Parashurama we all know. Parashurama is one character who appears in Rama, in several places of course. In Ramayana he appears very briefly after Sri Rama's marriage. After Sri Rama's marriage, while all these people, they were returning from Mithila to Ayodhya. Mithila is the place of Sita. From there to Ayodhya, they were returning. And there, suddenly Parashurama appears. And Parashurama, from what we see in films, he is portrayed as some sort of villain, a sort of minor villain. But there, if we see that Parashurama story, Parashurama, he comes, and then of course he challenges Rama. He says, okay, it seems in fact, Parashurama uses very, very polite language. Very polite language. Ramayana, if you read, we have to always read the original book. Whenever we are in some doubt, we should always go to the original Ramayana, original Bharata, or original Bhagavatam. Otherwise, there are so many distorted versions either in the later classics. For example, Ramayanam has been much altered by Tulasidas. Tulasidas Ramayana, that whatever Ramacharita Manasa, and then it has been altered by various other people in various other languages. But whenever we have to know what exactly is there in the original, you have to go to original Ramayana only. So there, the language used by Parashurama is really polite. Oh, you are a warrior, you are a great fighter. So he actually compliments. Then he says, okay, you have done that. You try to put a string on this bow. So Rama very casually takes it and then puts a string and then also puts an arrow on that. Then he says, having put an arrow on this, I can't leave it just like that. I don't want to kill you because you are a Brahmin. You tell me, I want to hit either, all the lokas which have been attained by you. I am telling that story because we are now in the context of lokas. All the lokas which have been attained by you, I want to hit. Or I will hit your ability to move. The Parashurama, by that time, he had conquered all the world, according to the legend, according to the Purana. And then he had donated it to one sage called Kashyapa. So he was not supposed to stay there. He was supposed to go only and stay in one Mahendra Parvatam. So his ability to move cannot be cut. So he cannot afford. Then when the option is given by Rama, either I will hit all the lokas, I will destroy all the lokas which have been attained by you, or I will hit your mobility. Then he says, no, don't hit my mobility because I have to go and do my tapas in that Mahendragiri. You hit all my lokas. Then what does it mean? It actually symbolizes that Rama has taken away this ahankara from him. Rama has given him this Atma Vidya. He is showing him that all these lokas are unimportant. He has just made him realize that all the lokas which have been attained by him, they were all attained at the stage of ahankara. In fact, that line, there is a line from Ramayana I had noted somewhere, Tatah pradakshini kurtya jagama atmagatim vibhuhu. Jagama atmagatim vibhuhu means all those lokas and all that, they are gone. Now Parashurama is in that path of that Atma, Atmagati, Atma realization. So that is what Ramayana says. So we have to read those original episodes if we have to see what exactly that episode means. So this is that I found very relevant in the context of describing what exactly is a loka. So all these lokas which we accumulate by doing some good deeds and all that, they are at a secondary level according to Vedanta. The idea is that we have to get out of them, we have to overcome them and then go to some higher level. So we have completed up to that. Avidya kamavata eva sarvani karmani srautadini darshitani. Okay, next let us read. Tebhyo vyuthaya pravrajanti.
Tebhyo vyuthaya pravrajanti.
Iti vyuthanam.
Iti vyuthanam.
Atmanam eva lokamichyato.
Atmanam eva lokamichyato.
Akamasya vihitam.
Akamasya vihitam.
So there is a kami. We have talked about this kami. Now we are talking about one akami. Akamasya, for somebody who is not desirous of these lokas. So what is prescribed for him? Akamasya kim vihitam. What is that which is prescribed for him? Vyutthanam. Vyutthanam is rising above. Vyutthanam is rising above these things. That is what is meant by rising above. That is renouncing. There again in that so kamayata, in that context, Shankaracharya in that bhashyam, not only in that bhashyam, even in the text, vittaishanayasya, daraishanayasya, lokaishanayasya, vyuthaya brahmacharyam charanti. That is what that Brahadaranyaka line says. There is one brahmanam that is called Brahmavidya Brahmanam. Brahmavidya Brahmanam. The first adhyaya, fourth brahmanam, it is 17th mantra. 17th mantra in the fourth brahmanam by name Brahmavidya Brahmanam. There it says, vittaishanayasya, putraishanayasya, lokaishanayasya. So vittaishana, vittam is the money. Putra is son, we know. Lokaishana, we have seen all this thing about lokas, all these special places. Loka, we should not be confused that there is some special loka and all that. It is a special place of a special state of existence for whatever good deeds he has done. So he is supposed to be in a happy state. So that happy state is called a loka. So all these lokas which have been attained, that is again a eshana. Eshana is desire. Kamana. Eshana means kamana. So lokaishanayascha, vittaishanayascha, from all these eshanas, these three eshanas, they call it eshana trayam. From that yeshana trayam, we are supposed to rise above. So that is called vyutthanam. Vyutthanam is getting above these three types of desires, these three yeshanas. So that is what is that. Tebhyo vyutthaya. Tebhyaha means This is in plural. Tebhyaha, from them. What are those three? What is meant by them? He is referring to those three eshanat, three desires. Tebhyo vyuthaya pravrajanti iti vyuthanam atmanameva lokamichyataha akamasya vihitam. For akama, for a man who is desirous of knowledge, for a man who wants to be in the path of knowledge, this vyuthanam is vihitam. Vyuthanam is renunciation. So you have to give up that desire for loka, desire for putra and desire for vittam. So that is the message meaning here. Tadetad vibhaga vachanam anupapannam syat yadi shrautakarma jnanayoho samuchayo abhipretaha syat bhagavataha. Okay, now he says, he is talking, now the question is, whether this samuchaya which they are contemplating, are you talking of samuchaya with a shrauta karma or are you talking of samuchaya with a smartha karma? Samuchaya, you remember, samuchaya means combination, combining. Why not? He is a safe player. He doesn't want to lose either jnanam or karma. So he wants to do both. It is something like trying to travel by two trains which are going in the opposite direction. One train is going somewhere, another train is going in another way, and he is keeping his two legs on these two trains. When these two trains move, he will be maybe torn apart or he will fall somewhere in the middle. So it is like that. This is samuchaya. Is it with shrauta karma or is it with smartha karma? So that is the question here. Tad etad vibhaga vachanam anupapannam syat yadi shrauta karma jnanayoho samuchitaha abhipreta syat bhagavataha. By bhagavataha means by the Lord. Whether, if, I mean, in case that samuchaya was intended, abhipretaha syat means had it been intended. Abhipretaha means abhipraya. Abhipretaha syat means had it been intended, what that samuchaya, had it been intended, samuchaya of what? Shrauta karma, jnana yoho. This jnana karma, jnana and shrauta karma. If the Lord, if Krishna had intended, say, this sort of combination between these two, then this vibhaga vachanam anupapannam syat, this type of division, this type of discrimination would have been inappropriate. The fact that we are seeing that these two things are very clearly divided by the Lord, it shows that the Lord did not intend a combination of these two. So that is the meaning of that line. Nacha, let us read. Arjunasya prashnaha upapanno bhavati.
Arjunasya prashno upapanno bhavati.
Jayasit chet karmanaste ityadi. असंभवं बुद्धि कर्मणोः भगवता पूर्वम् अनुक्तं कथम् अर्जुनो अश्रुतं बुद्धेश्च कर्मणो ज्यायस्त्वं भगवति अध्यारोपयेत् मृषैव जायसी चेत कर्मणस्ते मता बुद्धिरिति. इट इज अ लॉन्ग सेंटेंस, एनीवे विल स्लोली ब्रेक इट. न च अर्जुनस्य प्रश्नः उपपन्नो भवति जायसी चेत कर्मणस्ते इत्यादि. सो ही इज रेफरिंग टू वन क्वेश्चन विच इज गोइंग टू कम इन फ्यूचर, दट इज इन द थर्ड अध्याय, थर्ड अध्याय ऑफ भगवद्गीता, दट इज कर्मयोग. जायसी चेत कर्मणस्ते मता बुद्धिर्जनार्दन तत् किं कर्मणि घोरे मां नियोजयसि केशव. देयर इज अ श्लोक विच इज गोइंग टू कम. इफ युअर इंटेंशन इज दैट ज्ञान इज सुपीरियर टू कर्म, देन वाई आर यू पुटिंग मी इन दिस कर्म पाथ? सो दैट इज वॉट इट मीन्स. यू हैव देयर द वेरी क्वेश्चन ऑफ अर्जुन वेरी क्लियरली सेज दैट ही हैज अंडरस्टूड लॉर्ड्स मैसेज एज मीनिंग दैट ज्ञान इज सुपीरियर टू कर्म. सो दैट इज वाई ही इज पुटिंग दैट क्वेश्चन. इफ आई से दैट ज्ञान इज सुपीरियर टू कर्म and you very clearly understand that jnana is superior to karma, and still when I am asking you to do karma, then your question will become appropriate. Your question, or you yourself are saying that jnana is superior to karma, then why are you asking me to do karma? So that is the meaning here. Nacha arjunasya prashnaha upapannaha bhavati. Arjunasya prashnaha na upapannaha bhavati. Arjuna's question will not be logical, will not be appropriate, had Krishna intended some samuchaya, had Krishna intended some combination. Nacha arjunasya prashnaha upapannaha bhavati. What was that question? Jayasi chet karmanaste mata buddhir janardana. Jayasi is means greater, कर्मणः ज्ञानं बुद्धिः जायसी. बुद्धि मीन्स् बुद्धि इज नॉट मेंशन्ड हियर इन दट श्लोक इट इज देयर. जायसी चेत् कर्मणस्ते मदा बुद्धिर्जनार्दन. बुद्धि देयर इट डज नॉट रेफर्स टू इंटेलेक्ट, इट रेफर्स टू ज्ञानं. सो बुद्धि बिकॉज इट इज इन इट इज अ फेमिनाइन वर्ड, फेमिनाइन जेंडर. जायसी दट फेमिनाइन एंडिंग इज देयर. जायसी चेत् कर्मणः मता बुद्धिः कर्मणः जायसी दट इज बुद्धि, दट इज नॉलेज इज सुपीरियर टू कर्म. सो दट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दट फर्स्ट श्लोक ऑफ तृतीयाध्याय. सो अर्जुन हैज राइटली अंडरस्टूड लॉर्ड्स मेसेज, राइटली अंडरस्टूड दट ज्ञानम इज सुपीरियर टू कर्म. सो दट इज वाई ही हैज पुट दट क्वेश्चन. अर्जुन से प्रश्न न उपपन्न भवति जायसी चेत् कर्मणस्ते इत्यादि. सो हैड अर्जुन हैड से दिस मैन हैड कृष्ण इंटेंडेड ए कॉम्बिनेशन, अर्जुनस क्वेश्चन वुड हैव बीन इनअप्रोप्रिएट. देन एक पुरुषानुष्ठेयत्व असंभवम बुद्धिकर्मणोः भगवता पूर्वमनुक्तम कथम अर्जुनो अश्रुतम बुद्धेश्च कर्मणः जायस्तम भगवति अध्यारोपयेत् मृषैव. देन हैड अर्जुन नॉट हर्ड प्रॉपरली, had Arjuna not heard properly what say Lord Krishna had said, then how will he attribute, how will he attribute that to Lord Krishna? Had he not heard properly, how will he attribute? Yeah, you yourself have said. That means he has understood it properly, he has understood what Lord said properly, so that is why he is attributing those words to him. You yourself have said. So that is the meaning of this. ఏక పురుష అనుష్ఠేయత్వ అసంభవం. ఏక పురుష అనుష్ఠేయత్వ అసంభవం మీన్స్ ద ఇంపాసిబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ వన్ మ్యాన్ డూయింగ్ బోత్. ఏక పురుష అనుష్ఠేయత్వ అసంభవం, ద ఇంపాసిబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ వన్ పర్సన్ డూ బీయింగ్ ఆన్ బోత్ ద పాత్స్, దట్ ఈస్ ఆన్ ద పాత్ ఆఫ్ జ్ఞాన అండ్ ఆన్ ద పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ కర్మ. దట్ ఇంపాసిబిలిటీ హ్యాస్ బీన్ ప్రాపర్లీ అప్రిషియేటెడ్ ఆర్ ప్రాపర్లీ అండర్స్టూడ్ బై అర్జున. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్. దిస్ అసంభవం బుద్ధికర్మణో భగవతా పూర్వం అనుక్తం కథం అర్జున అశ్రుతం బుద్ధేశ్య కర్మణ జయస్వం. హ్యాడ్ అర్జున నాట్ హర్డ్ ఇట్ ప్రాపర్లీ, హ్యాడ్ అర్జున నాట్ అండర్స్టూడ్ ఇట్ ప్రాపర్లీ, హౌ వుడ్ హీ పుట్ దట్ క్వశ్చన్? జాయసీ చేత్ కర్మణస్తే మత బుద్ధి ఇది భగవతి. హౌ కెన్ హీ అధ్యారోపయేత్? అధ్యారోపయేత్ మీన్స్ హౌ కెన్ హీ అట్రిబ్యూట్? హౌ కెన్ హీ అట్రిబ్యూట్ ఫాల్స్లీ? మృషైవ, మృషైవ మీన్స్ ఫాల్స్లీ. జాయసీ చేత్ కర్మణస్తే మత బుద్ధిరితి. యూ అండర్స్టూడ్ దిస్ లైన్? The overall meaning I told you in the beginning itself. Next line. Kincha.
Yadi buddhi karmanoho.
Sarvesham samuchayah uktah syat. Arjunasyapi. Sa ukta eva iti. Yachreya yetayor ekam. Okay, now we'll read it. Yashreya, we'll read again. కించ యది బుద్ధికర్మణో సర్వేషాం సముచ్చయ ఉక్త స్యాత్ అర్జునస్యాపి స ఉక్త ఏవ ఇతి. విచ్ మీన్స్ కించ మీన్స్ అండ్ ఆల్సో, కించ మీన్స్ అండ్ ఆల్సో. యది బుద్ధికర్మణో సర్వేషాం సముచ్చయ ఉక్త, హ్యాడ్ కృష్ణ ప్రిస్క్రైబ్డ్ దిస్ సముచ్చయ, ఏ కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ బుద్ధి అండ్ కర్మ. బుద్ధి మీన్స్ ఇట్ డస్ నాట్ మీన్ ఇంటలెక్ట్, బుద్ధి మీన్స్ జ్ఞాన, ద పాత్ ఆఫ్ జ్ఞాన. బుద్ధి అండ్ కర్మ, హ్యాడ్ కృష్ణ ఇంటెండెడ్ దిస్ కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ టూ and had he prescribed for everybody, it would have been applicable for Arjuna also. Yadi buddhi karmanoha samuchaya sarvesham uktah syat. Sarvesham means for everybody, for everybody. Was it, had it been made a universal principle, then it would have been applicable to Arjuna also. So that is the meaning. Kincha, and also, yadi buddhi karmanoha samuchaya sarvesham uktah syat. Had it been told, had it been made a universal principle, అర్జునస్యాపి స ఉక్త ఏవ. ఫర్ అర్జున ఆల్సో ఇట్ వుడ్ హవ్ బీన్ అప్లికబుల్. యచ్ శ్రేయ, నెక్స్ట్ విల్ రీడ్. యచ్ శ్రేయ ఏతయోరేకం తన్మే బ్రూహి సునిశ్చితం ఇతి కథం ఉభయోః ఉపదేశే సతి అన్యతర విషయ ఏవ ప్రశ్న స్యాత్. ఓకే, యచ్ శ్రేయ ఏతయోరేకం తన్మే బ్రూహి సునిశ్చితం. అగైన్ ఈస్ దట్ ఫ్రమ్ ది సేమ్ శ్లోక. జాయసి చేత్ కర్మణస్తే మతా బుద్ధిర్జనార్దన తత్ కిం కర్మణి ఘోరే మాం నియోజయసి కేశవ. దేర్ ఆఫ్టర్ యచ్ శ్రేయ ఏతయోరేకం తన్మే బ్రూహి సునిశ్చితం, ద నెక్స్ట్ శ్లోక ఇట్ కమ్స్. एतयोः मीन्स् बिट्वीन् दीस् टु एतयोः मीन्स् बिट्वीन् दीस् टु यत् श्रेयः विच् वन् इस् सुपीरियर् विच् वन् इस् द श्रेयस् अण्ड् प्रेयस् अगेन् टोल्ड् यु विच् वन् इस् रियली सुप्रीम् विच् वन् लीड्स् टु दट् आत्मज्ञान यत् श्रेयः एतयोः एकं तन्मे ब्रूहि सुनिश्चितं यु डिसैडेड्लि यु डेफिनेट्लि टेल् मी यु मेक् इट् यु प्रापर्ली डिसैड् अण्ड् टेल् मी तन् मे ब्रूहि सुनिश्चितं सुनिश्चितम् इस् वेल् डिसैडेड् तत् मे ब्रूहि यु टेल् मी वाट् एक्साक्ट्लि इस् दट् इस् ए सुप्रीम् थिङ्ग् विच् इस् फार् मै सो वाट् इस् सुप्रीम् फार् मी दट् इस् दि मीनिङ्ग् आफ़् दिस् थिङ्ग् बिट्वीन् दीस् टु विच् इस् सुप्रीम् यु प्लीस् डिसैड् अण्ड् टेल् मी सो दिस् क्वश्चन् वुड् हेव् आल्सो हेव् बीन् इनप्रोप्रियेट् हेड् कृष्णा इण्टेण्टेड् ए काम्बिनेशन् दट् इस् द ओवर् आल् पिक्चर् हेड् कृष्णा इण्टेण्टेड् ए काम्बिनेशन् आफ़् दीस् टु आल् दीस् क्वश्चन्स् वुड् नाट् बि अप्रोप्रियेट् would not be logical. So that is the idea. Kincha yadi buddhi karma, this over, yach shreya yetayorekam tanme bruhi sinishchitam iti katham ubhayoho upadeshe sati. Ubhayoho upadeshe sati means had both been prescribed, had both these things been prescribed, anyatara vishaya eva prashneha syat. Anyatara vishaya means question relating to one. You tell me about one. There cannot be. And Shankara is giving an example. Sometimes Shankaracharya also jokes. This will let us read. Nahi pitta prashamarthino vaidyena madhuram shitalam cha bhoktavyam ityupadishte tayoho anyatarat pitta prashamana karanam bruhi इति प्रश्नो भवति सो ही इज मेकिंग ए स्लाइट रिडिक्यूल सपोज यू गो टू योर डॉक्टर एंड यू कंप्लेन दैट यू आर हैविंग दिस पित्तम पित्तम यू नो बाइल सम सॉर्ट ऑफ जूस ऑल सॉर्ट ऑफ सेक्रीशन ऑफ जूसेस इन द स्टमक सम अनप्लेजेंट सेंसेशन इन द स्टमक दैट इज कॉल्ड पैत्यम ऑल्सो कॉल्ड पित्तम पित्त प्रशम कारण पित्त प्रशमार्थी दिस मैन He is going to a doctor in order to suppress that prashama is control or cure that pittam. So he goes to a doctor and then the doctor prescribes madhuram sheetalam cha bhoktavyam. He told you eat something sweet and also which is cold. Madhuram sheetalam cha. So he is prescribing a combination. The doctor here is not like Krishna, he is prescribing a combination. So he is saying madhuram sheetalam cha bhoktavyam iti upadishte. Once that has been prescribed, tayoho anyatarat pitta prashamana karanam bruhi iti prashno na bhavati. Tayoho anyatarat, between these two, you tell me one. He says, you eat something which is sweet and also cold. So then this man cannot ask, you tell me whether I have to eat the sweet one or a cold one. He should not ask. So once that combination has been prescribed, then Arjuna would not have been asking that question. So Shankaracharya is making it more and more clear by giving a more very earthly mundane example. Yat shreyayeto iti katham ubhayoho upadeshe sati anyatara vishaye prashnah syat nahi pitta prashamarthinah pitta prashamarthi is the person who is desirous of controlling his bile. Prashamarthi arthinah is again the shashti vibhakti. Pitta prashamarthinah vaidyena by the doctor madhuram sheetalam cha bhoktavyam ityupadishte you eat both madhuram and sheetalam once had it been prescribed tayoho anyatarat between these two tell me one between these two tell me one pitta prashamana karanam bruhi tell me one between these two one so that sort of prashna that sort of question would be inappropriate then We can again visualize another type of situation. Suppose Arjuna has not properly understood what Krishna has said. Krishna told something and Arjuna has not properly understood. So that is what he is going to say in the next line. Atha Arjunasya
Bhagavadukta Vachanartha
Viveka Anavadharana Nimittaha Prashna Kalpyeta तथापि भगवता प्रश्नानुरूपं प्रतिवचनं देयम् मया बुद्धिकर्मणोः समुच्चयः उक्तः किमर्थम् इत्थं त्वं भ्रान्तोऽसि यस् अथ देन् अर्जुनस्य भगवदुक्तवचनार्थ विवेक अनवधारण निमित्त प्रश्न कल्प्येत. सपोज वी प्रेज्यूम दैट अर्जुन इज पुटिंग दीज क्वेश्चंस बिकॉज ही डिड नॉट अंडरस्टैंड दिस डिस्क्रिमिनेशन विच हैज बीन मेड बाय द लॉर्ड. लॉर्ड हैज मेड अ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन और अ डिस्टिंक्शन, नॉट अ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन बट डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन दीज टू, बुद्धि एंड कर्म. बुद्धि मीन्स ज्ञानम, ज्ञानम एंड कर्म. लॉर्ड कृष्ण हैज ऑलरेडी मेड अ डिस्टिंक्शन. Suppose we presume that Arjuna is putting this question because of his lack of understanding, because of improper understanding of the distinction which has been made by the Lord. That is the meaning of this. Atha Arjunasya Bhagavadukta Vachanartha Viveka Anavadharana Nimittaha. Anavadharana means not understanding. What? Not understanding what? Bhagavadukta Vachanartha Viveka. That is, Viveka is distinction. The distinction which has been made by the Lord in his words. If you are taking that as the reason for question of this, for Arjuna's question. You follow? So if we presume that Arjuna has put these questions because of not understanding the words of the Lord, so that is the overall meaning. Bhagavadukta vachanartha viveka anavadharana, not understanding, anavadharana nimittaha prashnaha kalpiyata, tathapi bhagavata prashnanurupam prativachanam deyam, which means then Lord Krishna should have answered according to the question. According to the question asked, then he should have said, no, I told you something else, you have understood wrongly. He would have told like that. Had Krishna intended samuchaya, then he would have told, no, I intended samuchaya. Why are you asking this question which I did not tell? Why are you mistaking me? You have wrongly understood me. He ought to have said, so he did not say that. So that is the meaning. Tathapi bhagavata prashnanurupam prativachanam deyam. Prashnanurupam prativachanam means his reply would have been in accordance with the question, in accordance to the question asked. So, but here he says, and what should have been that? Maya buddhikarmanoho samuchayaha uktaha. That means, by me, buddhikarmanoho samuchayaha uktaha. Samuchaya means combination. Combination of karma and jnanam has been prescribed by me. Why are you unnecessarily confused? That should have been the question, but that should have been the reply of the Lord, but that is not the reply of the Lord. So which means Lord Krishna never intended this samuchaya. The overall message is Lord Krishna never intended samuchaya. We cannot in any way presume that either Arjuna has wrongly understood. So we cannot presume it like that also. So that is the idea. Maya buddhikarmanoho samuchaya uktaha. किमर्थम त्वम इत्थम त्वम भ्रांतोसि. किमर्थम, why आर यू सो कन्फ्यूज, why आर यू कन्फ्यूज लाइक दिस. नेक्स्ट, नतु पुनः प्रतिवचनमननुरूपम् पृष्टात् अन्यदेव द्वे निष्ठे मया पुरा प्रोक्ते इति वक्तुं युक्तम्. देन अगेन, हियर अगेन ही इज रेफरिंग टू द सेम थर्ड अध्याय. द्वे निष्ठे मया पुरा प्रोक्ता मया नख ज्ञान योगेन सांख्यानां कर्मयोगेन योगिनां. दट श्लोक इज गोइंग टू कम इन द थर्ड अध्याय. ही इज रेफरिंग टू दट श्लोक. लॉर्ड वुड नॉट हैव रिप्लाइड लाइक दट. ही वुड हैव सेड, से हैड कृष्णा इंटेंडेड समुच्चय, ही वुड हैव सेड यू हैव रॉन्गली अंडरस्टूड मी. बट कृष्णा डिड नॉट से लाइक दट. ऑन द अदर हैंड ही सेड, यस आई हैव मेड अ डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन दीज टू. द्वे निष्ठे मया पुरा प्रोक्ते. Two nishta, I told you. What is nishta? Nishta means nishchayena avasthanam, nishchayena sthitihi. Being in something very firmly, that is called what is nishta. It may be a good thing or a bad thing. I also told you somebody may have a nishta in making money, somebody may have a nishta in something else, some other vice. So, but nishta means nishchayena avasthitihi. Having a great shraddha in a particular thing. So, dve nishte maya prokte, that is what Krishna is going to say. Sankhya Nishta, Yoga Nishta, that's what he is going to say. So, Dve Nishtemaya Pura Prokte Iti Navaktum Shakyam. Lord Krishna never intended, the overall meaning is Lord Krishna never intended this type of samuchaya. So, that is why he gave a reply saying that, yes, two types of Nishta have been told by me. Next question is, and visualizing another situation. Now, we have discussed samuchaya with Shrauta Karma. There is another thing called Smartha Karma. What is Smartha Karma? Shrauta Karma is something like which has been prescribed by the Shruti or Veda is Shrauta. where something like Darsha Purnamasa Ishti, then Swargakamo Vijeta, something like that, some Somayagam, it is also called Agnishthomiyam. So there are certain things which are prescribed in the Vedas. There are other things which have been prescribed in the Smritis, like say Vapi Ishtapurtam. Ishtapurtam is, that is, the digging of wells. Vapi is one type of well. Kupa is another type of well. Tataka is another type of some ponds, creating of ponds. These are all things which we do for loka hitam, that is, for the welfare of people. So there is a long route. People used to dig some wells here and there so that all the passengers, they would take water from that well. So that well will be useful for anybody who is a traveler by that route. So all this thing is, it will get you some punyam. Then there are some minor vratams, some Satyanarayana vratam, some Chandi vratam, some other vratam. There are some other small yajnas, not mentioned in the Vedas. So all these things come under Shrauta. So the question here is, maybe Lord Krishna intended this Samuchayavadi is a sort of diehard. He is not leaving him. So Samuchayavadi is putting all types of arguments. Maybe Lord Krishna intended Samuchaya with a Smartha Karma. So he is denying even that. He is referring to Yuddham, which is a Smartha Karma. Yuddham for a Kshatriya is a Smartha Karma, which is something which is prescribed. Smartha Karma, I told you, Smritis prescribe this karma. A Brahmin has to do this, Kshatriya has to do this, Vaishya has to do this. And for a Kshatriya, Yuddham is a Kshatra Karma. And how can Krishna himself be saying you do that? There is no question of then these two things. So that there is no question of refusal of this Smartha Karma here. Let us read this line. Napi Smartenaiva Karmana Buddhehe Samuchaye Abhiprete Vibhaga Vachanadi Sarvam Upapannam Kincha Kshatriyasya Yuddham Smartam Karma स्वधर्ममिति जानतः तत्किं कर्मणि घोरे मां नियोजयसि इत्युपालम्भो अनुपपन्नः. सो अर्जुन वुड नॉट हैव टोल्ड लाइक दैट तत्किं कर्मणि घोरे मां नियोजयसि केशव. योर इंटेंशन इज दैट ज्ञान इज सुपीरियर टू कर्म, देन व्हाई आर यू फोर्सिंग मी टू एक्शन. अर्जुन वुड नॉट हैव पुट दिस क्वेश्चन. This action is of the nature of Smartha Karma. This action may not, it is definitely not the nature of a Shrauta Karma, but it is of the nature of Smartha Karma. Arjuna would not have put this question had Lord Krishna prescribed Samuchaya. Kim Karmani Ghore Imam Niyojesi. So Arjuna, in Arjuna's mind, even this Yuddham, which he is saying, that is something which is not prescribed by Lord Krishna. So that is why he is putting that question. You are saying that Jnanam is superior, then why are you asking me to do to this karma? Arjuna would not have put this question. So that is the meaning. Tat kim karmani ghore imam niyojesi keshava iti upalambha. Upalambha is something like a small, it is not exactly taunting. Because Arjuna and Krishna are very, very friendly. Arjuna is actually the brother-in-law of Krishna. So some liberty he takes. And upalambha. Upalambha is some taunting. Very, very closely, when you are very close with a person, you sometimes say, okay, how can you say this? It doesn't mean disrespect. It is not due to disrespect, but some little bit of it shows some proximity, it shows some closeness. So this upalambha actually means taunt. But this here, we should not take it in a serious way. We should see that it only shows their proximity. This sort of upalambha, it would have been anupapanna. It would have been inappropriate had Krishna prescribed a samuchaya between a smartha karma and jnana. So that is the meaning. So he is now concluding. This discussion about whether a samuchaya is with a smartha karma or a shrauta karma is coming to an end here. Tasmat, Gita Shastre, Ishan Matre Napi. Shrautena smartena va karmana Atmajnanasya samuchayaha Na kenachit darshayitum shakyaha Na kenachit means by anybody. Nobody can show in Gita Shastra, nobody can show this sort of prescription of a combination of jnana and karma. This prescription of combination of jnana and karma cannot be shown by anybody, by any stretch of imagination, by any stretch of argument. You can't show that. So that is the meaning. Tasmat, therefore, Gita Shastra, in the Gita Shastra, Ishan Matrenapi, not a little bit. Ishan Matrena, not a little bit. Shrautena va, smartena va, karmana, Atma Jnanasya Samuchayaha Darshayitum Makenachit Shakyaha. Nakenachit Shakyaha. That is, this combination of this Atma Jnana with Shrauta Karma, either Shrauta Karma or Smarta Karma, is just not possible. This, you nobody can demonstrate it in the Gita Shastra. So next para, this is a new argument which is coming up. I will tell the meaning first so that we can follow it. Now he is referring to a person who is engaged in karma, who is doing some Jyotishthoma or some other yajnam he is doing. And while doing, so in our say scriptures we see that in the process of yajna goes on not for one day, it goes on for several days. So there are so many scholars who are available, who will be present. And then during their break times, there will be some discussion. There will be some discussion on what is Atma, what is the ultimate reality and things like that. So those breaks are called Pariplava. So during those, in Brahma Sutras, there is an Adhikaranam called Pariplava Adhikaranam. So Pariplava Adhikaranam, it's the basic question is, Brahma Sutra, all this discussion on this Brahma is all irrelevant. They were just interludes. Interludes means something which was just discussed, just for spending time. All these scholars who sat together, they were just passing time, just whiling away their time, they just discussed these things, but this is not essential. That is the Purvapaksha there. So there is a Adhikaranam called Pariplava Adhikaranam. The Siddhanta is that it is not like that. That is the main purpose. So while doing an yajna for several days, so the Yajamani, he keeps on listening to that. Not only Yajamani, even the Rutvik who is doing all that and then keep on listening. Then there is a discussion on what is Atma. Atma vare dashtavyaha shrotavyo mantavyo nididhyasitavyaha. All these lines they read. All these lines they listen. And then there is a discussion on those lines. Karma is going on at one stage. So from morning 8 to 12 or so, they do all these rituals and all their mantras are there. All those homa sacrifices are all over. Then maybe during lunch time or maybe after lunch they sit for an hour and then discuss these things. They don't discuss, in those days there were no films or anything. So there was no other discussion, there was no other entertainment. So probably they discussed only these things. So there, suppose there is some sudden change in your mind. While doing yajna itself, you suddenly realize, yes, all these things is something which is not very important. Suddenly some wisdom dawns on you, then what is the status of that karma? So that is the hypothetical question here. There is a hypothetical question which is anticipated by Shankaracharya. You are doing a karma, and while doing karma, for some reason, some wisdom dawns on you. Then whatever you are doing, will it be called a kamya karma, or what is the status of that karma? So that is the question here. Let us see this. Yasyatu. अज्ञानात् रागादि दोषतो वा कर्मणि प्रवृत्तस्य यज्ञेन दानेन तपसा वा विशुद्धसत्त्वस्य ज्ञानमुत्पन्नं परमार्थतत्त्वं विषयं एकमेव इदं सर्वं ब्रह्मा अकर्तृ च इति तस्य कर्मणि कर्मप्रयोजने च निवृत्तेपि लोकसंग्रहार्थं यत्नपूर्वं यथा प्रवृत्तिः तथैव कर्मणि प्रवृत्तस्य यत् प्रवृत्तिरूपं दृश्यते न तत् कर्म येन बुद्धेः समुच्चयः स्यात् दिस् इस् अ फेर्ली लाङ्ग् सेण्टेन्स् यस्य तु अज्ञानात् रागादि दोषतो वा वी ऑल स्टार्ट कर्म बिकॉज ऑफ टू थिंग्स इट हैज बीन सेड वेरी मच इन द बिगिनिंग अविद्या कामवतः एव सर्वाणि कर्माणि दैट हैज बीन सेड वन हू इज हैविंग अविद्या एंड आल्सो काम डिजायर आई वांट दिस लोक आई वांट दिस लोक ऑल दिस वन हू इज डिजायरस ऑफ गेटिंग सो मेनी लोकस ओनली ही विल बी एंगेज्ड इन सम बिग कर्म कर्म मीन्स सम एक्टिविटी सम यज्ञ आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट अवर मुंडेन्स सोशल कर्मस बट कर्मस विच हैव बीन प्रिस्क्राइब्ड आइदर इन द श्रुति और स्मृति सो समबडी हू इज एंगेज्ड इन दिस बिकॉज ऑफ अज्ञान एंड काम रागादि दोषतो वा कर्मणि प्रवृत्तस्य फॉर समबडी हू इज एंगेज्ड इन दिस फॉर दैट मैन व्हाट हैपेंस समवेयर इन द मिडिल यज्ञेन दानेन तपसा वा विशुद्ध सत्वस्य सो व्हाइल डूइंग यज्ञ as I said this pariplava some discussions and discourse during in that time danena the yajna also involves some danas here and there every time there is a danam and while giving danam say there is a mantra which says the person who is giving danam is brahma the person who is taking danam also is brahma ganesho pratigrunhati ganesho vaidadadisha in fact tomorrow you are going to say that because tomorrow is vinayaka chaturthi It is the giver is Vinayaka and the taker is Vinayaka. What does it mean? So when he listens to all these things, in our all rituals, we should remember one thing. Rituals are, we are doing. But then the mantras, they are at two levels. Actually, almost every mantra, you can see two levels. One is at a mundane level. Then again, it also shows the Parabrahma, the supreme level also, the same mantra shows. In every place, in all pujas also, they talk about Sabrahma, Sashiva, Sahari, Sendra, Sotsharah, Paramaswarat, we say, whenever when we are doing that, say, puja, so this is Brahma, this is Shiva, this is Rudra, this is that Akshara Parabrahma. So, when we see, the old people, they were not like us, they knew Sanskrit fully well, they were all scholars, they were not like us. So, the meaning of the mantras was very well known to them. So when he is reciting those mantras every day, at some time the fellow really, the wisdom dawns on him. He says, yes, after all what I am doing is having a limited purpose. So yajnena danena tapasava, tapasa, tapasa means alochana. The meaning of word tapa is alochana. Tapa alochane, that is the original, that is the actual meaning. So tapas does not mean some simply sitting somewhere and then growing a long beard and all that. Tapas is alochana. Tapasava Vishuddha Sattvasya. For this man, the Chitta Shuddhi takes place while doing Yajna. Any Yajna or Nishkama Karma, even if here he is not even talking of Nishkama Karma, he is talking about a Kamya Karma only. Even such a man, there is a possibility that this fellow, there is some wisdom dawning on him. Vishuddha Sattvaha. Suddenly this man, he is acquiring some Chitta Shuddhi. For such a man, Jnanam Utpannam परमार्थ तत्व विषयम् परमार्थ तत्व विषयम् परमार्थम् इज द सुप्रीम रियलिटी परमार्थ परम इज सुप्रीम परमार्थ तत्वम् व्हाट इज दैट एकमेव इदं सर्वम् ऑल दिस इज वन दैट इज द स्टेटमेंट सर्वम् खल्विदं ब्रह्म ऑल दिस स्टेटमेंट्स आर देयर आई एम आत्मा ब्रह्म सर्वम् खल्विदं ब्रह्म दिस एंटायर थिंग इज ओम सो ऑल दिस स्टेटमेंट्स ही रीड्स एंड देन ही अंडरस्टैंड्स एकमेव इदं सर्वम् ब्रह्म अकर्तृच I am an akarta. That also he realizes. The same mantras, while doing karma, it also says, I am akarta. So he realizes that also. Brahma akartrucha iti. Tasya karmani karma prayojanesha nivruttepi. For such a man, karma and then karma prayojana. What is that karma prayojana? Karma prayojana is chitta shuddhi. Karma prayojana means it can mean phalam, karma phalam, or karma the other phalam is chitta shuddhi. There are two phalams for karma. One is whatever loka or whatever desire you have, that desire also, that phalam also is there. In addition to that, there is a chitta shuddhi also. If you really do that karma with some little bit of attention to the mantra, if you pay attention to the meaning of the mantra, it will definitely give you some chitta shuddhi. So that is the meaning here. Karmani tasya for such a man, who has got some chitta shuddhi karmani karma prayojanesha nivruttepi karma is nivrutta karma prayojana also is gone karma prayojana is that chitta shuddhi also it has been attained nivruttepi loka sangrahartham yatna purvam yatha pravruttih loka sangrahartham then why is he doing karma he is doing karma for loka sangrahartham this word loka sangraha is again we will be going to get, we will be seeing it in the fourth chapter, in the text itself, we are seeing. कुर्यात् विद्वांस तथा असक्तः चिकीर्षु लोकसंग्रहं कर्म व्हाट इज दैट श्लोक सक्ता कर्मण्य विद्वांसः यथा कुर्वन्ति भारत सक्ता कर्मण्य विद्वांसः यथा कुर्वन्ति भारत कुर्यात् विद्वांस तथा असक्तः चिकीर्षु लोकसंग्रहं दैट इज व्हाट इट श्लोक सेज इन अनदर श्लोक आल्सो दैट वर्ड लोकसंग्रह कम्स लोकसंग्रह देयर शंकराचार्य एक्सप्लेन्स इट एज preventing somebody from going in a wrong direction. That is loka sangraha. Loka given, when there is no direction to it, they will go in all types of wrong directions. So there should be somebody to give some direction to that loka. Loka means not the entire world as such, a person. Loka it can also mean jana. Loka ha jana ha. So there is a need to give proper direction to the people. So that proper, giving some proper direction is what is loka sangraha. Lokasya unmarga pravritti nivaranam loka sangraha, that is what he is going to say. Unmarga pravritti is going in a wrong direction. Nivaranam, that is preventing people from going in a wrong direction is loka sangraha. That definition he is going to say subsequently. Loka sangrahartham yatnapurvam yatha pravrittihi. Yatnapurvam yatha pravrittihi means when that wisdom had not dawned on him, he was doing karma. In the same manner, he will do karma for loka sangraha. Before the dawning of wisdom, he was doing some karma. Then after this understanding, some proper understanding, the samyak buddhi, after that arising of samyak buddhi, after that proper understanding has arisen in him, even then he can continue to do karma for what? For loka sangrahartham. As a sort of role model, I was saying, a jnani who is doing karma is something like a role model. That is what it means. A loka sangrahartham, to prevent people from going in a wrong direction. Unmarga pravritti nivarana. So loka sangrahartham yatnapurvam yatha pravrittihi tathaiva karmani pravrittasya. Karmani pravrittasya. For this gentleman who is continuing in this karma, yat pravritti rupam drushyate na tat karma. Whatever you are seeing is not karma. He is doing karma, but at the same time he is saying it is not karma. Yena buddhehe samuchayaha syat. You can't say, because this gentleman is doing karma, yes, here there is a karma samuchaya. You should not say. Because the moment jnanam comes, karta is no longer there. This point we have to very clearly understand. The moment that understanding arises, karta is no longer there. Once karta is no longer there, then there is no question of samuchaya. Samuchaya is there only when there is karta. I am doing this for me. So when that karta is there can be samuchaya. The moment proper understanding, the moment that samyak jnanam, samyak buddhi arises in a person, then karta himself has disappeared. When that karta is not there, there is no question of samuchaya. You can't call it samuchaya even though you are seeing a karma. The jnani may be doing a karma, but you can't call it a samuchaya. Jnani karma is akarma. So that again we are going to see in the fourth chapter. We are going to see what is karma, what is vikarma, what is akarma. We are going to see. But this is all a sort of introduction which Shankaracharya is giving. All this, what we are going to see in future, even if we don't understand it right now, we will see it more elaborately when these proper shlokas come. So this, very briefly he is saying, a jnani karma is not a karma, because a jnani, in the case of a jnani, that karta is no longer there. Once karta is not there, karma phalam is not there. So that samuchaya you cannot say. Yat pravrutti rupam drushyate na tat karma yena buddhehe samuchayah syat. Is it okay? Yatha
bhagavato vasudevasya
kshatra karma चेष्टितम्
न
ज्ञानेन
समुच्चियते
पुरुषार्थ सिद्धये तद्वत्। ओके, देन ही इज गिविंग द एग्जांपल ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा हिमसेल्फ। व्हाट डिड लॉर्ड कृष्णा डू? लॉर्ड कृष्णा, यू कांट से ही इज नॉट ए ज्ञानी। लॉर्ड कृष्णा इज कृष्णम वंदे जगद्गुरुम, ही इज द लॉर्ड ऑफ द यूनिवर्स, ही इज द टीचर फॉर द एंटायर यूनिवर्स, ही इज द मैन हू इज इम्पार्टिंग दिस नॉलेज फ्रॉम टाइम इमेमोरियल। इमं विवस्वते योगं प्रोक्तवान अहम अव्ययम् विवस्वान् मनवे प्राह, दैट्स फोर्थ चैप्टर इट सेज, this particular yoga I told in the beginning of the creation, I told, he says, that is, he is of that nature, his real tattva is that Brahman. So he, you can't say that Lord Krishna himself is an ignorant person. So Krishna is a jnani, and Krishna, he is doing this kshatra karma right now because of his upadhi. Right now, what is the upadhi of Krishna? The upadhi of Lord Krishna is that he is a kshatriya now. He may be a yadava, but he is a king. So long as he is a king, he is a kshatriya. You can't say yadava is different and kshatriya is different. All this discussion which is now in the present day only. So that is kshatra karma. He is engaged in kshatra karma. So yataha yatha bhagavataha vasudevasya kshatrakarma cheshtitam na jnanena samuchyate na jnanena samuchyate purushartha siddhaye tadvat. You are not going to say that Lord Krishna is doing this karma for a purushartha. Lord Krishna is definitely not doing this karma for any purushartha. Here the purushartha is na jnanena samuchyate purushartha siddhaye. Here purushartha means jnana, jnana siddhaye. You can't say that Lord Krishna is doing this for achieving jnana or for any purushartha. So likewise, tadvat, now the next line, tadvat, phalabhisandhi, ahankara abhavasya tulyatvat, vidushaha. This line is a very great line, which is equating jnani with Lord Krishna. Anybody who is a jnani, and anybody who is engaged in karma, he is almost kept on par with Lord Krishna. That is what it says. Tadvat, likewise. Tadvat means likewise. Phalabhisandhi ahankara abhavasya tulyatvad vidushaha. Vidushaha. Vidushaha means for a vidwan. The word is vidwan. Pratipadika is vidwan. For vidwan, the shashti is vidushaha. For a vidwan and Lord Krishna, these two things are common. What are they? Phalabhisandhi ahankara abhavaha. Phalabhisandhi is not there, ahankara is not there. Phalabhisandhi and ahankara, for both vidwan and also for Lord Krishna, these two things are not there. Phalabhisandhi means desire for the fruit of an action. Then ahankara, I am doing this, kartrutva bhava. These two things are not there, both in the case of Krishna and also in the case of a vidwan. So that is what he is saying. So now the first hypothetical question. First hypothetical question, what was that? Somebody who has started a karma in the realm of ignorance, and in the process, somehow, because of his, he is keeping a close watch on the meaning of the word, mantras and all that, somehow that wisdom dawned on him. Then what will happen to his karma? The answer is, whatever he does is not karma. Yena buddhehe samuchaya syat. You can't say that it is samuchaya. And he is giving the example of Lord Krishna himself. Lord Krishna, who is doing kshatra karma, you can't say that Lord Krishna is doing it for the sake of jnana or for the sake of some other purushartha. Likewise, the jnani also, jnani is equated to that. The common thing, what is in common between jnani and Lord Krishna? Phalabhisandhi ahankara abhava. Phalabhisandhi is not there, ahankara is not there. Is it okay? Phalabhisandhi is desire for the fruit of action. Ahankara is kartrutva bhava. These two things are not there in the case of both Krishna and also in the case of a vidwan. Next line. Tattva vittu. Naham karomi iti manyate. Nacha tat phalam abhisandhatte yathacha swargadi kamarthinaha agnihotradi kama sadhana anusthanaya ahitagnehe kamye eva agnihotradau pravurtasya सामि कृते विनष्टेपि कामे तदेव अग्निहोत्राद्य अनुष्ठितोपि अनुतिष्ठतोपि अनुष्ठित अनुतिष्ठत भवतर्थम् अनुतिष्ठतोपि न तत् काम्यम् अग्निहोत्रादि भवति. The same thing he is explaining. Whatever we discussed till now, he is explaining, he is giving in different words. Then, yathacha, tattvavittu na aham karomi iti manyate. Tattvavit. Tattvavit means one who is a jnani, one who knows tattvam. So that gentleman, how does he think? न अहम करोमी इति मन्यते आई एम नॉट द डूयर ही इज वेरी क्लियर इन हिज माइंड ए ज्ञानी इज वेरी क्लियर इन हिज माइंड दट ही इज नॉट द डूयर ही इज अकर्ता गुणा गुणेशु वर्तन्ते दट ऑल्सो ही इज गोइंग टू से दट ही फील्स दट वट एवर ही इज डूइंग इट इज द उपाधि धर्म दिस देहम इंद्रिया ऑल दिस इंद्रियास अंतकरण दिस आर ऑल उपाधिस टाइम इज ओवर वन मिनिट ओनली I think we'll close it here. This line we'll take up next class. There was some doubt. Shall we take it up in the next class? Tattvavittu naham karomi iti manyese na tat phalam abhisandhate yatha swargadi kamarthinah agnihotradi kama sadhana anusthanaya ahitagnehe. This is a long line. We'll take it up in the next class. Then there was one doubt by one listener. The question is this. In the first introductory class, you mentioned that there are three runams. First being Rushi runam, what are the other two? Did I miss them? Yeah, because I don't know whether I clearly told all these three runams. There is a Rushi runam, there is a Pitru runam, there is a Deva runam. There is a mantra which says, Jayamano vai brahmana tribhir runavan jayate brahmacharyena rushibhyah prajaya pitrubhyah yajnena devebhyah prajaya pitrubhyah. So there are three runas. A man, he is born with three types of indebtedness. Indebtedness to three different agencies. One is rishis. Rishi means the rishis who have composed our Vedas, rishis who have given us this inheritance, this intellectual heritage. So this intellectual heritage we are supposed to protect. So that is what is called Rushi Runam. And how do we repay that Rushi Runam? Only by Swadhyaya and Pravachana. You are supposed to read this Gita and then you are supposed to tell somebody else, tell your son or tell some student, catch hold of some fellow and then you have to teach this thing. So then only you will be out of this Rushi Runam. You will be repaying that Rushi Runam. You will be going out of that indebtedness. So the Rishi, Brahmacharyena Rishibhyaha means Brahmacharyam is what? Brahmacharyam does not mean being celibate. Brahmacharyam is Brahmani Charati iti Brahmachari. That is being dedicated to this Brahmajnana. That is Brahmajnana which is conveyed to us through our Upanishads, through Gita, through Brahma Sutras and all that. That Prasthanatraya which contains that Brahmajnana. We are supposed to dwell on that. We are supposed to understand Swadhyaya and also Pravachana. So that is the Rishi Runam. Then Pitru Runam. Pitru Runam you are supposed to do by marrying and also by begetting children. Prajaya Pitrubhyaha. That means the Pitru, the sons, they will give those Pindodakas and all that. So for all the forefathers, for the three generations of forefathers, we do this Pindodaka and all that. So that is by way of, the way to get out of that indebtedness. Then Yajnena Devebhyaha. By doing, performing this Yajnas, which are mentioned in this, Devebhyaha. Then for the gods, how is the way to get out of that runam? That is by performing yajnas. In fact, for yajna, we are going to get a very large meaning, a very, wide meaning, it's a very wide meaning will be given for this yajna in the fourth chapter. Yajnarthat, karmanonyatra, etc. There are a few shlokas which give a very wide meaning for the yajna. Yajna is not only a ritual, but anything, jnana yajna, there is what is called a jnana yajna. That jnana yajna also is more, in fact, that is the greatest yajna. That is what we are going to see. So these three runas, Deva runam, Pitru runam and Rishi runam, these are the three runas. Then another doubt is about, it is the desire of the creator to restore order in the society. How can creator have an attribute called desire? Yeah, this is a very, very relevant question in the sense that we have to understand that the Supreme Brahman is something which is akartru, asanga, akartru. Yes, we can't even call it he. In the very first day, we remembered that we have to call it it. So that is the nature. But this, from this maya, we have visualized certain god forms. And there is some order in society. There is some universal order. तानि धर्माणि प्रथमान्यासन एटसेट्रा वी रीड इन पुरुष सूक्त तानि धर्माणि प्रथमान्यासन सो ऑल दीस धर्मास ऑल दीस ओरिजिनल धर्मास ऑल द ओरिजिनल प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ द यूनिवर्स दे आर अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ सम क्रिएटर वी आर विजुअलाइजिंग वन सच क्रिएटर एंड देन दैट क्रिएटर इज द पर्सन हू इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ दिस अवतारस दिस अवतार अगेन whenever there is some uprising of adharma and whenever there is say whenever dharma is taking a beating then some avatara comes that that creator's amsha only is coming as an avatar so in that form in a very limited context we say that creator is having an intention it is not attributed to the ultimate brahman it is attributed to the saguna brahman these two levels of brahman we have to understand the saguna brahman and the nirguna brahman then the third is about some people have gotras that are different from the names of saptarshis this I am not sure about it how can we know the names of the prajapati for these gotrams we do not know in fact people say that there are marichyadin srushtva prajapatin so that is what it says so the first sambandha bhashyam says marichyadin srushtva prajapatin say pravrutti dharmam nivrutti dharmam cha grahayamasa vedoktam so something like that so that prajapatis there are varying lists in varying places saptarshis we know कश्यपः अत्रि भरद्वाज विश्वामित्रोश गौतम विश्वामित्रं विश्वामित्रश्च गौतमः जमदग्नि वसिष्ठाश दट सप्तैते ऋषयस्तथा बट सम अदर बुक आर सम अदर पुराण मे बी गिविंग सम अदर नेम्स सो हाउ दीस वेरियस गोत्रास आर कमिंग वी डू नॉट नो बिकॉज दिस वी हैव टू सी सम अदर लिटरेचर मे बी सम पुराण वी हैव टू वेरीफाई आई एम नॉट वेरी श्योर विद दिस It is my request to Advaita Academy not to delete the recordings. Okay, this of course, Advaita Academy is going to preserve all these things, and the promoter of this Advaita Academy, Mr. Harikiran, he is promising that all these things, all these lectures, not only my lectures, but all other there are several other speakers who are talking on different subjects. All these things they will be available on the YouTube after some time. So this is the picture. So we'll close with this. This long line we'll take in the next class. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति शांति शांति